Good evening, everyone. For this week's post, I chose Molly Pitcher for my Woman of the American Revolution to research. The tale of Molly Pitcher, the female heroine of the Battle of Monmouth in June 1778, is famous for its themes of valor, fidelity, and patriotism of the principal character who took her husband's place on a cannon after he fell in battle. She remained with the crew through the end of the fight, serving as an inspiration to others and a model of dedication to the cause of American liberty even today. However, not everything in the story of Molly Pitcher is accurate or possibly even true. Still, the central theme holds enough credibility for her story to remain a positive example of women patriots and their contributions in the American Revolution. Proof of this lay in the fact that a memorial in her honor was placed in the cemetery at the United States Military Academy at West Point, near where what are believed to be her remains were buried with full military honors. The legend of Molly Pitcher stems from several stories of the time, but the most popular, or likely, is that of a woman camp follower carrying water to soldiers on the battlefield when she saw her husband fall. In her work, An Introduction to the Legend of Molly Pitcher, Carol Claver notes the heroine is based on one or two women, Mary Hazy McCauley or Margaret Cochran. Claver describes the similarities of the stories where both women took their husband's place on the cannon at the Battle of Monmouth. She points out that, quote, most historians who believe Molly Pitcher was a real person see her as Mary McCauley, but Margaret Corbin probably contributed more to the myth than we realize, end quote. Both were followers of their husbands, who were both in the artillery. However, there is documentation of Corbin's war experience mainly from the Battle of Fort Washington in 1776, where she in fact did take the place of her husband on a cannon after he fell. There are records of her recognition by Congress in 1779 for that service, and she was called Captain Molly thereafter. Claver notes the first printed version of the Molly Pitcher account came from George Washington Parker Custis, Martha Washington's grandson. He places the story at Monmouth, therefore much of his writings were later believed to be, quote, the source of the legend, end quote. Claver acknowledges how, quote, an exchange of facts is very strong, end quote, in these stories, and that it is difficult to verify or validate stories of women during the Revolution because not much information is available to do so. Emily Lewis Butterfield commented in her work, Lie There, My Darling, While I Avenge Ye, how some anecdotes from the Revolution lasted only a short time, yet the stories of Molly Pitcher, quote, multiplied and expanded over the course of decades, end quote. Butterfield describes the life of the Molly Pitcher legend and how in many accounts no specific details were relayed to connect her to any one real person, allowing some stories to use a level of creative license to provide their own picture of the female heroine. Butterfield noted that although the Pitcher story was often repeated and modified to some degree across the 19th century and into the 20th, the common theme throughout was her patriotism and wifely devotion. She states, quote, her example suggests that the appeal of collective memories that bolstered national identity and existing norms encouraged Americans to ignore contradictory accounts, even when provided by living witnesses, end quote. Emily Type notes in her article, Will the Real Molly Pitcher Please Stand Up?, how difficult it can be to sometimes distinguish the legend from the reality. This is especially difficult when dealing with a person like Pitcher who, Type notes, quote, has held a revered place in the patriotic lore of the American Revolution right next to Betsy Ross, end quote. Type subscribes to the theory of the Pitcher persona being drawn from a combination of sources and events. She also describes some of the difficulties encountered when seeking proper recognition for women and their role in the Revolution. The ones who did seem to be able to do so through a male sponsor for their deeds. In summary, though, Type states, quote, despite the extraordinary service of all the Molly Pitchers in the American Revolution, the republic that was established was still a man's world. As female veterans returned to the patriarchal society where their contributions went unrewarded and largely unrecognized, only the heroic imagery of Molly Pitcher commemorated their patriotism. Thank you.